two feet and eight little tails they fly. Faster, faster, faster through the sky. Oh, look at them go. Santa laughing.
Ho, 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 ho.
Dasher, Dancer, Prancer, Vixen, Comet, Cupid, Donner, Blitzen over the garden wall. 32 feet and eight little tails in all. See them canter, hear old Santa call. Merry, Merry Christmas to you all.
I got my fur hat out of the loft, especially. So that is it for today's show, and indeed for this year. Thank you to everyone who sent in a request, and thank you to all of you who have kept me company on the radio this year. It's been great having you, and I hope you'll stick with me into the new year. There's all sorts of treats here on Radio 2 on the big day itself, including the songs that bring you joy with Gabby Roslin, the most streamed number one Christmas records with Steve Wright, and the King's Speech for the first time in 71 years. And I will be with you again next on Sunday, the 8th of January, 2023. Thanks to my producer, Jessica Rickson. She's staying off my naughty list again this Christmas. And I hope you have a very Merry Christmas. I'm Elaine Page, and this is Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker, and on 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 3 o'clock. This is Nikki Cardwell. The Football World Cup final between Argentina and the reigning champions France has just kicked off in Qatar. The tournament's top two goal scorers and Paris Saint-Germain teammates Lionel Messi and Kylian Mbappe are going head-to-head as they try to secure victory for their countries. Our sports correspondent Ollie Foster is at Lusail Stadium.
Argentina against France, that doesn't tell half the story of what we've seen here in Qatar over the past month. So many twists and turns and shocks. Think of Morocco reaching the semi-finals, but this could be a final for the ages. Both nations looking to lift the World Cup trophy for a third time. Will it be Argentina? Will it be France? Two great, great sides in the history of this tournament.
A 19-year-old has been charged in connection with the deaths of four people when a migrant boat capsized in the Channel. 39 people were rescued off the Kent coast early on Wednesday. Vincent McAvinney has more.
The Kent police have announced this afternoon that a 19-year-old, Ibrahima Bar, of no fixed address, has been arrested. In a statement, they say the Crown Prosecution has authorised a charge against him of knowingly facilitating the attempted arrival in the United Kingdom of people he knew or had reasonable cause to believe were asylum seekers. He's been remanded in custody and will appear at Folkestone Magistrates Court on Monday.
The cabinet minister with responsibility for strike contingency planning has insisted that the government will be resolute in response to union demands for higher public sector pay. Oliver Dowden said it would be irresponsible to allow public sector wages and inflation to get out of control. Nurses in England, Wales and Northern Ireland are due to hold a second day of strike action on Tuesday, followed by ambulance staff in England and Wales on Wednesday. The head of the armed forces, Admiral Sir Tony Radakin, says military personnel should not be regarded as spare capacity for striking workers. The government's confirmed that 1,200 troops and 1,000 civil servants will be drafted in to cover for striking ambulance and border staff around Christmas. Colonel Richard Kemp served in the British Army for more than 20 years.
I think it's definitely a role the armed forces should be playing if they have to, obviously as a last resort, if nothing else can be done. But nevertheless, that's why they're there. Ultimately, they are an extremely reliable organisation that can be depended upon to keep emergency services, whether it be borders or ambulance, whatever it is, running when everything else breaks down. So it's an entirely appropriate role for them.
Human rights groups and celebrities have called on Iran to...